To rent homes in Southwest Florida, say they are stuck. Their homes are damaged, but landlords either will not respond or refuse to do the repairs. Thanks for watching NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. We have been sharing advice since Ian hit. What to do if your home has been badly damaged? NBC2 investigator Evan Dean is digging into your rights as a renter.
Yeah, Peter and Kelly, I just spoke with attorney Andrew Epstein, who says he has been getting calls nonstop since the hurricane, mostly from renters who are dealing with damage. He says communication with your landlord is key, not just calls or texts. He suggests going as far as sending a written notice outlining your problems and what needs to be done.
You would send it to the landlord, you can email it to the landlord, you can hand deliver it to the landlord, and you say what things need to be fixed.
But what if the damage is so bad it's unfixable?
The statutes say that if the damage is not caused by the tenant, and the damage is so significant that it makes the property untenantable, the tenant can terminate the tenancy without notice to the landlord.
Problem is, where do you go if you do have to leave? That's an entirely different problem altogether. Say you can stay, you have to, but the place needs fixing and you can't get in touch with your landlord at all. Epstein offers this advice.
If the place is a mess, you've got to protect yourself and your family. That's number one. You do what's best for your family. If you can live in a house, in a property, and do some things to protect the property at the same time, as a tenant, be the bigger person and do those things. You don't want to put your family at risk with mold and water and the like, so you too have an obligation to do that. Whether you can turn to your landlord, and your landlord's going to be reasonable and reimburse you for some of those expenses, That's a problem that's going to be something we're going to see for months and months to come.
Yeah, look, Epstein expects a big fight over money, specifically deposits and who owes what. Tenants may be entitled to expenses under certain circumstances, but that all depends on the case. And I cannot stress this enough. Each case is different. There's not one answer that we can give to everyone. Your best bet, contact an expert, share your situation, and get advice that's specific to you. We do have resources on who you can contact inside this story in the NBC2 News app. Back to you.
Evan, thanks.